Well, in yesterday's video, I think I freaked a lot of people out. This one's worse. We're talking Armageddon. Also, you guys had asked, when is this all gonna go? Well, you're in the trajectory right now. You're about right there. You wait. And I used the example yesterday of doubling pennies, like 31 days. It ends up being, I don't know, a lot. Well, $11 million in 31 days. Go 32 days, you got 20, LA Unified Math. But I also don't think that I made it clear, like, because you're like, well, where are we at? Let's say we're at day 21 or maybe day 22, 23. 24. Not so bad. It's bad, but it's not like 21 trillion bad. And it will be. And it's going to hit the banks. It's going to hit you. And you're seeing it. I mean, you're seeing this sweet little debt-based system play out. S&P Global downgrades. No. Really? Five U.S. banks warns lenders hold billions of dollars in loans that may face material deterioration, also known as you ain't getting your money back. When banks started failing last year, it was quick, right? It was like, I was in Australia and I'm like, what the hell is going on? Glad I work every single day. S&P downgrades First Commonwealth Financial Corp, MNT, Bank Corp, I don't know, Trustmark, and Valley National Bank Corp. And they went from, all of a sudden, they were stable to negative. It's almost like the Fed going from stable to negative. And these aren't just little problems. This just the banks on commercial real estate, what, 21 trillion? And the Fed ain't fixing it. No one's fixing it. There's the Fed's balance sheet. It's all starting to end. And you can only have a system for so long where money's free, right? Just go to New York. You could even be a migrant. Give you a debit card. Do whatever you want. We are in the do whatever you want. And normal people are thinking, this can't go on, can it? I come here to tell you, if history repeats, you are looking at a full-blown civil war. And I have documentation to prove it. See, people are starting to get a little upset. You know, wise people that know how to bite their tongue till it bleeds because you've been through a marriage. Maybe a second or third, then you just figure out, yeah, I'll just bite. Because 50% is a lot of money. There just comes a point, and I think we're looking at November. That will be the straw that breaks the camel's back. I mean, look at this. Migrants along border says they quote, want Biden to win in the 2024 election. And some of you are like, well, they can't vote. Oh, really? Well, let's not go down that rabbit hole. Also, I do want you to understand that I gather news from everywhere. And then I put it in my brain and I go, this is right, or this is wrong, or this is maybe. And then I also come to you and go, you know what? I think I was wrong on that one. For some weird reason, money is very important to me to understand, where does it come from? Where is it going? Who creates it? Our economy, can it survive based on this system? So I read and do a lot of audio tapes. Here's one, Lords of Finance, The Bankers Who Broke the World. Might be a tough read unless you have like a double PhD. You may wanna move down to the Lords of Easy Money. And actually, one of the channels that I subscribe to, maybe you could think about subscribing to mine, Uneducated Economist. He does go long. Long is not something that I have been blessed with, but this one caught my eye. The video was, the economy will only get worse. Listen, look, just quick 5 seconds. Let's go.
In today's video, I thought I would talk about how there is no solution.
Also, I sped him up.
There is no fixing the economy. There is no way of reversing the problems that you are experiencing within the environment that we are now experiencing, whether it's inflation or loss of jobs, layoffs, can't afford, you know, the prices out there, the rent or whatever it is that's going on. There is no fix. There's no fixing this. There is no solving it. There is no way that they can come up with a system that is going to benefit everybody and that everybody is going to be happy with. It just doesn't work like that. And so what I thought I would do is I would read a little bit from Cantillon's essay. Cantillon.
You guys may want to look at that one. That is what I've been trying to explain to you for I don't know how many years. Now, I may have been early to the game. So was Noah. And it's like playing Russian roulette. You're right until you're wrong. Or you're wrong until you're right. Also does make me think, how many times do you think Noah did go to Home Depot? Well, Bible scholars believe Noah made over 977 trips to Home Depot during the Ark's construction. Also, for those of you that leave comments, you do know that the Babylon Bee is satire or humor. Well, you do know that Johnny Bravo is satire and humor. So yes, I am aware that Noah did not make almost 1,000 trips to Home Depot. Pop the confetti, truth be told, most of the stories that I do that are true, they're almost like too crazy to even believe. This is what just happened in Houston. There goes your wing. You know, you really, you didn't need that anyways. And there goes the CEO who just walked away with $33 million in compensation. Good job, buddy. And actually, it's going to be difficult to even know what's truth and what's not with this coming election. Actually, most things I'm like, let's figure this one out. Let's try to use logic, which throw that one out the window. By the way, China is using AI powered social media accounts to influence the US elections. Microsoft is warning you. So that should bode well with civil war. Would you not agree? Let's go back to my main story. Well, I mean, I feel like I have so many, and then I try to put them all in a blender and I try to make sense of it. Because the economy is complicated. Everything that's going on around you is complicated. The news stories, half of them are basically untrue. I mean, even something like this, the strong US job market, which we already went over, that is a sweet spot, economists say. Look, the economy added 303,000 jobs. That is just, I'm trying to pinch to zoom. We ain't pinching, and oh, there we go. We be zooming. 303,000 jobs in March. We also have basically no unemployment. But what they fail to tell you, right, is this is part-time. Here's full-time down here. And if you could kind of see, it's going in a specific direction. Everyone is losing their jobs. I have pointed news story after news story. I mean, the US government could probably lay everyone off and we would have all-time job numbers. Actually, news articles say this is a great thing. This is great for GDP. This is great for the economy, which I'll get into that, because a lot of those people that are now here, it's kind of dangerous. So be careful tomorrow. Don't gather around, because you may be blown up. I'm sure if that happens, it'll probably be Donald's fault, right? But I mean, these things are in your face. I showed you this increase in California. Burger King was $15. Texas, $15. And now you're paying $17 over the course of one day. Don't worry about it, kids. We don't have inflation. And actually, in a debt-based system, inflation's really difficult, because money is debt. And then if you pay off the debt, you get rid of the money, and it's hard to get inflation. Looks like Janet pulled it off, or Jerome. 10 trillion, 20 trillion, let's keep going. How many bonds do they need to create? But then there we are again with our exponential curve. I just feel sorry for the government that has to pay it back with interest, or the American public that has to pay it back with interest from their paycheck. And we're going to hit $2 trillion next year of just interest, and then $3 trillion following that. And that's just the beginning. You just wait. Buckle up, buttercup. It must be so confusing, because people will see companies go out of business, like this story, and then you see their stocks go up. But like what I've said a trillion billion times, please do not equate the stock with the company, or the company or the economy with the stock market. Actually, I kid you not, M&T Bank up today. That's great. $138 a share. And how confusing this must be for people. Above the 200, almost $140 a share, but you couldn't get above that line there. You may want to keep this one on your little watch list. I mean, that got rejected 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And then it come down, and then you break that line. Now, does that mean, because you just saw this news story, and should you run out and short it? No. How about now? How about now? No confirmation yet. I do have stocks that do have confirmation in my watch list. If you're new, start with my bull market watch list. Well, first start with my swing trading course. Also, link in the description, 80% off, because it is solar eclipse 24 hours. And once that's done, the sale's over. For those of you that ask in the comments, I keep having to repeat the same thing. Start with swing trade, then go to bear market. See, market go up, market go down, and then market go sideways. That would be options. These are options. These were my options in my watch list. That was JBL, and I don't want to explain it to you, because it's there, and if you know, you'd see it. How much did we do? What was that? That was Wednesday. That was just a few days ago. How much money have I made on that? Oh, let's see here. 26%. That's good. That's just one Bravo. Well, I go Wednesday. I had this one on there. STLA. Here we go. See? Bravo 9, purple nurple below the Bravo. You see that? The 9, the little red line. Also, something that you can't see. There's, see that line? How it's going straight? Here, I will show you going straight. Difficult with this hair. This, see? Straight line. See this? Up line. One of them is line. Well, I picked it and I said it was line. And I gained only 125% on that trade. Okay. See, I bring you problems. I bring you global problems, but I also give you solutions that make your digits go up. Paper trading only. And then I also give you warnings like this. This was in a bulletin, law enforcement. I used to do law enforcement. Just got pulled over again. Man, do not get a Cybertruck, black it out. Seeing Black Mirror film, they will look for anything. And today I had lunch. Thank goodness I did not drink anything. And I came out. It was private, not public. So I don't turn on my blinker because I know the law. And he pulled me over. And he's like, you didn't use your blinker. I'm like, you just wanted to see the truck. I want to know how many times I pulled someone over when I worked law enforcement for not turning on their blinker. Zero. I was like, you do know it's private property. But anywho, just wanted to chase a squirrel. I was very nice too. I smiled. He said he was going to be a politician someday. I said, you'll get my vote. In a bulletin to law enforcement obtained by ABC News, the FBI, DHS, possible threats to gatherings because people are coming over the border in droves, millions. And guess what? Shocker, some of them might be really bad people that want to blow you up. But there is no one stopping this because rumor has it they actually vote a certain way. Shocker. Well, hey, let's burn everything down. You see how I connect all the dots and see this is why. And people tell you everything's good. And I'm like, well, you know, we do have like take delinquency multifamily housing highest since 2013. I'm going to go with bad. Or insurance companies deciding, you know what? We're not going to give you insurance. California is going to be a shat hole. It's an okay word. It is Sunday. It is a Christian word. You can use shat hole. Insurance companies are now using drones to find reasons to cancel your home insurance. I mean, when this thing really goes, I don't know. What are you going to do? And how are you going to pay all this back? How's the government going to pay all this back? How are you going to pay all this back? Credit card debt, all-time high. Government, all-time high. Recession, all-time high. National debt, all-time high. Everything, all-time high. And I actually kind of feel like Noah, but it's raining now, right? I'm watching the rain. Everyone's like, wow, I've never seen this before. Because there wasn't. Like, if you don't get on the yacht, you're all gonna die. Oh, no. Noah, Moses, you've been saying that forever. I said Noah and Moses because sometimes I tell Bible stories and then I'm like, oh, wrong one. Yes, I know. Stock market go up, even though they're downgraded. Like, okay, I'll trade it. Or when the government tells you everything's okay, I don't know how to trade that. I guess that's macro. Macro, not a good trade. But anywho, it is time to get more gooder and more smarter and put things in your brain so you know how it all works. And then you don't have to get mad at that. And you can trade it and make your digits go higher. So hopefully you're doing something. You're coming to my show, where I make a complete idiot out of myself every single day in front of 212,000. I mean, do I really have over, that's too many. Not too many. I love you guys. Thank you for subscribing. It's just frightening. And what's even crazier is you guys know, I give you all my details. Even when I picked up the Cybertruck, a guy who owned all the buildings came out and he's like, Bravo. I wasn't sure if it was you because you don't own a car. But thank you also for being so nice to me. If I see you or if I don't see you and you see me, come say hi. I will give you a hug. I will shake your hand, whatever you want. And I love you and I will see you tomorrow. That was kind of creepy, I know, but I'll see you tomorrow.